ben Regine Ederveen en this is lesson 1 of how to play the harp. The harp, of course, is a beautiful instrument and I want to learn to play it now. So go on, let's start. I advise you to get a harp with levers. Those little things are called levers. You see? Okay. If you have a harp without levers, don't worry, be happy. Just go on with the lesson, it doesn't matter at all. We will learn a little song. I will play it on the harp at the second half of this film. Tuning. Without tuning, there is no harp which is in tune. Harps always need to be tuned. Okay, I take this tuning key, I press it on the metal pin, I look if I put it on the right pin, the pin which connects with the central C. This red string is called the C. And the one which is about 1 millimeter thick is called the central C. It should sound like this. Okay, we learn to tune. Just listen to my harp, compare it with your harp, and if we sound the same, then we are in tune. What you also can do is that you click on the online keyboard link below this film, and then you will see a keyboard. And the key called C3 is the central C. Right. This string should sound as central C. Usually when you buy a harp, it sounds a little bit lower because it hasn't been tuned for a while maybe or so. Like this for example. Oh boy, what should we do now? We take the tuning key, we press it on the right pin, we turn it anti-clockwise while playing with your left hand. And you can listen. This should be the central C. I will now play it once, and then after that you can press on the pause button in this film. Try to tune your harp the same. Okay, you can press the pause button. Keep the tone in your memory. We'll go to the next string on the right hand side of the central C. This one is called the D. Okay, the D from Delaware, for example. It should sound like this. If not, for example, like this. Oh boy. Turn it anti-clockwise higher. Stop when it's this sound. Okay, you tuned 2 strings already. Congratulations! Now we will go to the next string. This is a special one. It's called an E flat. What means E flat? It means it's a tone between the D and the E. And if you go to the online keyboard, you can see it's the black key between the white D key and the white E key. So it's a half tone between those D and E tones. It should sound like this. Okay, you've got it. We will go on. The next one is the F from Florida. The next one, the G from Good. And then we've got a flat one again. The A flat. A flat. The A from America. And the flat because it's a half tone between G and A. So it's a little bit lower than A. And on the keyboard, it's the black key between the G and the A. Confusing? Well, maybe a little bit. And we will go to the next one. It's called the B flat. And that is the one between the A and the B. It should sound like this. What I need to tell you is that while tuning, all the levers are down, so not up, because then you will get very confused on the rest of the lessons. But all levers down. If you don't have levers, don't worry, just tune the harp the same way. Now we end up at the C. This should be a red string. If not, make it red, please. Buy another string which has the color red. Put it on your harp. And it needs to sound like this. Okay, another four. The D. And then E flat again. Then F from Florida again. And then G from Good. Okay, we're there. So if you have a harp with only 12 strings, for example, you can simply tune it like this. Till this one. And now the second half is the song we were going to learn. It's called Brian Boru March. I will play it with my second finger of my right hand, like this. Tuning, and you just simply go down by every string, five strings. Then you start one string lower, which is called the F, and you do that two times. Then from the G again. The C, and we don't play the D, so we skip that one, and then you will get C, E flat, F, G, and then back again. The notes of this song are written down below this film, so if you can't do it by heart, just look at the notes C, D, etc. And you can learn it that way as well. I will do it once more in a slow mood. And I change my hands because some people are left-handed. And if you're double-handed, like me, do it with two hands. See a lot of music on my channel, YouTube channel. Anyway, have fun, enjoy harp playing, and thank you for your attention.